John was very, very, very smart, as you can imagine. It was his PhD in aero, and he was also very strong-minded, strong-willed. He had to be. He had to keep, because he had to keep fighting. I was a friend of John Houbolt here at Langley. Of course, John had a real struggle persuading the folks in our agency that the very best way to get to the moon was not the use of a huge monster rocket that would take off from here, land on the moon, and then take off from the moon, land back. It was just completely impractical.
John was in many technical areas. John had very strong ideas. And I'm sure you're familiar with the fact that his, you know, his approach was adopted only after he sent a note, personal note, to Siemens, who was the new administrator at the, you know, at the time.
The agency looked carefully at all the numbers that Dr. Houbolt came up with to show that it was more efficient and the best way to do it. So finally, he won the day. And that was a grand day for John.
That's John Houbolt. I mean, he's a prince among technical innovators.